Welcome to the Investors Trading Academy, talking glossary of financial terms and events. Our word of the day is basis point. Investment professionals regularly refer to basis points when discussing things like bond yield, mutual funds, or lending rates. Why does this seemingly tiny unit of measure, one basis point is equal to 1/100th of a percentage point, get so much attention? It's pretty simple. Basis points can add up to a lot of money for both individual investors and institutions. The relationship between percentage changes and basis points can be summarized as follows. 1% change equals 100 basis points, and 0.01% equals 1 basis point. Basis points are used as a convenient unit of measurement in contexts where percentage differences of less than 1% are discussed. The most common example is interest rates, where differences in interest rates of less than 1% per year are usually meaningful to talk about. For example, a difference of 0.10 percentage point is equivalent to a change of 10 basis points. For example, a 4.67% rate increases by 10 basis points to 4.77%. In other words, an increase of 100 basis points means a rise by 1%. Like percentage points, basis points avoid the ambiguity between relative and absolute discussions about interest rates by dealing only with the absolute change in numeric value of a rate. For example, if a report says there's been a 1% increase from a 10% interest rate, this could refer to an increase from 10% to 10.1%.